let's hear from a subject matter expert about pre-budget expectations in IT and BPM sectors.
Let us look at what the IT BPM services sector expects from the budget which is coming up in July. If we were to take a sneak peek at the contribution of this sector to India's economy, it contributes to roughly about 6.6% of the Indian economy. Its total foreign exchange earnings was about US$130 billion. Total revenues was in the range of US$180 billion. And it contributes to roughly about 66% of India's export revenues. So therefore, it's a fairly significant industry in the Indian economy. Now, most of these exports happen out of special economic zones. If you were to look at the status of SEZs in India today, 58% of SEZs in India are occupied by the IT service sectors. Out of the 223 operational SEZs, therefore, most of these are occupied by the IT service SEZs. There are also vacant spaces today in SEZs. So as to revive the SEZs of India, the Baba Kalyani report had issued their recommendation sometime in November 2018. They had recommended that we should make SEZs as investment economic hubs as against to export hubs. Given the Indian IT potential, given the vacant space in SEZs, I think there is a good case to support the Indian IT sector, and more so by supporting them operating out of the SEZs. One of the tax incentives, therefore, what the government should think of doing is to remove the sunset clause which is today there for operating out of SEZs, the Section 10AA tax holiday. Today, only if a SEZ unit is set up before March 2022 will they be entitled, otherwise they don't stand to get. So this needs to be relooked by the government. Alternatively, the 25% corporate tax rate should be extended to all companies, because today only companies earning less than 250 crores in turnover stand to get the benefit, not everybody.